Welcome to the ET335 RC Circuits Lab Demo. I'm going to demonstrate a circuit based on our Scribble quiz. Here's our calculations from the RC Scribble quiz of a short time constant at 6 kHz and 50% duty cycle. So these are the numbers we came up with. So I'm going to use a 0.01 microfarad capacitor and an 833 ohm resistor. Okay, I've opened up MultiSim. Let's build our RC circuit. So let's go ahead and grab some grounds. I need a couple of them, so let's just go ahead and put them in here now. And we're going to need basic, so let's go ahead and grab a resistor. We'll make it a 1K and we'll come back and change him. And then we need a capacitor, so we're going to use a 0.01. And our short time constant uses a capacitor input, and we're going to read over our resistor. Okay, so we're going to need a clock voltage. So let's go to signal, grab our clock voltage. And he's going to need a ground also. Okay. So we have our RC circuit. So let's go ahead and use our Tektronix scope. We might not need that one. So let's go ahead and take our input channel and our output channel. And I think our wire colors don't make any difference here because we're going to use the standard input of the oscilloscope. So let's go ahead and fire it up. And as usual, we're going to so let's make these both 5. See what we get. And let's spread it out a little bit. And let's go ahead and do a synchro. There we go. And let's move it a little bit. That is a good. Now let's do it a little. Let's try again. There we go. So what we have here is our differentiated waveform, the spiky one based on up and down. So let's make that a 1, see if we get that a little better. There we go. That is a good differentiated waveform. Okay, I made a couple mistakes here. Let's go ahead. This should be 6 kilohertz. And a resistor should be 833. Minor details. All right, let's fire it up and see if we get a decent signal. And yes, we do. It's still looking good. So as electronics, we pretty loosey-goosey, so as long as we get close. Okay, so let's modify this circuit, and we're going to modify the resistor too. But let's go ahead and shut this down and reverse the components. Okay, so we're going to use the same type size capacitor, but there's a factor of 100 difference. So you really need to do the calculation here, but I'm going to cheat a little bit, and I'm going to add 100 on this guy. Two zeros. And see if we could get it to work. All right. And this one is not going to be as large as the other one, so we may have to turn the scope up a little bit to see what's going on. So let's go ahead and fire it up. And I forgot to put my put the one I want on here. There we go. And let's shut off channel one. And this we need to turn up quite a bit. And the best way to do that is to go to AC coupling. And that way we could see it. So we're going to have to turn him up. Let's go to single. And that is our integrated waveform. Okay, and you see it goes from plus to minus. And it's pretty small compared to our last differentiated waveform.